so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Nicely done, ladies.
Thank you. And now for tonight's starting lineups. Starting for the Eagles. A senior setter from Reading, Pennsylvania. Number 4, Reese Ganter. An outside hitter from Reading, Pennsylvania. Number 5, Tyler Goldsboro. A middle from Easton, Pennsylvania, number 8, Chris Mellor. A sophomore opposite from Long Island, New York, number 9, Tyler Phillips. An outside hitter from Carlsbad, California, number 18, Campbell Gerdeman. And a middle blocker from Reading, Pennsylvania, number 20, Luke Hoffman. And at libero from Palos Park, Illinois, number 11, Jeremiah Burden. The Eagles are coached by Glenn DeHaven, and he is assisted by Brandon McDonough and Joseph Chambers. It's nighttime. Starting for the Knights, a junior from Sao Paulo, Brazil, number 1, Cristo Bianchi. And outside, the high-flying junior from Mesa, Arizona, number 4, Jeremy Brown. A junior opposite from Carlisle, Pennsylvania. Wham, bam, thank you, Sam. Sam Canlin. He's ruggedly handsome from Palmyra, Pennsylvania. The setter, number 10, Tyler Schaefer. That outside hitter, a junior from Palmyra, Pennsylvania, number 11, Christian Schaefer. And an opposite from Gilbert, Arizona, number 18, Kyler Evans. And at libero, the Las Vegas Assassin, number 6, Justin Madsen. The Knights are coached by Tom Peterson, and he is assisted by Gabe Wagner, Cheryl Peterson, Russell Tompkins, Steve Rasmussen, and Jeff Tomlinson. Let's play volleyball.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to tonight's broadcast for another edition of Southern Virginia Athletics. Today's Division III men's volleyball contest is looking to be one of the most exciting of the year, a top 10 matchup between the number 8 ranked, nationally ranked, Eagles of Juniata College and your number two nationally ranked Knights of Southern Virginia University. Both these teams in the CVC Conference, both respectively 1 and 2 in the conference, both having fantastic years so far. The Eagles of Juniata College coming in here at an 18-4 overall record, 3-0 in conference play, currently on a 13-game winning streak, and their last loss was back in February, the beginning of February, February 3rd, against number 3 nationally ranked Stevens, 3-1. Southern Virginia, of course, 20-0 on the year. They have still yet to lose a single set so far this season. They're 4-0 in conference play, number 1 in the CVC, and as I mentioned before, ranked number 2 in the nation in Division 3. And so I think it's easy to say this could be one of the best matchups we see here on Knights Broadcasting or in men's volleyball in general of the year. Knights fans and students and parents are here in droves, excited to see this fantastic matchup. There's been a great rivalry over the past about 6 years between these two programs. The Knights currently hold a 8-1 advantage historically over the Eagles, going back to 2018, which is the last time Juniata beat them, which was Southern Virginia's inaugural season as a men's program, or very early on in their history. And so I'm Dawson Weidrich, and I'm thrilled to be joining you for this ride in what should be the toughest challenge for both these programs so far this year. Against Southern Virginia, they faced off against tough teams, including recently, you know, against Lancaster Bible, where they swept that one as they have every game this year. We got Crystal Bianchi back to serve for the Knights of Southern Virginia. He'll kick things off here. Service error to start things off. Not at all the way the Knights would like to begin this night. So quick point to the Eagles with number 4, Reese Ganter, back to serve. He is joined by Campbell Gerdeman, as well as Luke Hoffman. And service errors back to back. The nerves maybe getting to both teams a little bit. Want to round off those who are starting for the Eagles. You also have libero number 11, Jeremiah Burden, on the floor. Number 5, Tyler Goldsboro. We'll talk plenty about him tonight, I am sure. And you got Tyler Phillips. So back-to-back-to-back service errors for both squads. And for Southern Virginia, on the floor for them, you have Jeremy Brown, Tyler Schaefer, Christian Schaefer, Kyler Evans, Justin Mattson, and Sam Canlin. In fact, Sam's twin brother Paul was here, or I guess he is here. He gave the opening prayer to begin tonight's festivities. Back serving is Goldsboro. Finally, we have a serve that either team can work with. Schaefer coming from the back row. Good dig there from Gantner. Good work there for Canlin. And that's going to be out, and the Knights find themselves quickly down 3-1. Back to serve once again is Tyler Goldsboro. I mentioned we talk about him a lot because he was last week's CVC Player of the Week, as they went up against Eastern Mennonite and Hobart. Here's the set to Canlin. The ceiling coming into play there, despite the effort of Peter Curiato.
Back to serve, Jeremy.
So the Knights bring it back within one, and back to serve is Jeremy Brown. And a big question for Southern Virginia going into today's game is, how able to go will Jeremy Brown be? We saw him go down against Lancaster Bible, and he looked quite a bit in pain. That slips through the hands of Sam Canlin.
Point, Eagles.
And so another point to the Eagles.
Back to serve Virginia.
But we saw Jeremy Brown warming up before today's game, and he went up to Coach Peterson, and Coach asked him, how are you feeling? And he said, I'm feeling great. He's on the floor. Don't see any signs of it holding him back so far. Now back to serve is number 20, Luke Hoffman, senior from Reading, Pennsylvania. Good receive there from Mattson. Here's Evans. That was tipped at the net by number 18, Campbell Gerdeman. So brings it back within 1 point, and back to serve subbing in for the Knights is number 15, Maxim Sutton.
Back to serve number 15, Maxim Sutton.
Maxim Sutton has done a lot of subbing in to serve this year. Sutton, the junior from Brentwood, California. The ceiling once again affecting the play, and again, it hits the ceiling twice there. Juniata College not able to handle it on that play. We've brought it up many, many times before, how the ceiling here at the Barn can be a bit tricky for visiting teams. And it sometimes even comes back to bite Southern Virginia on occasion, as it's now tied 4-4 in this first set. What a job there for Christian Schaefer to get in the way, and I believe it ended up hitting number 9, Tyler Phillips, on the way down as well. So Southern Virginia takes their first lead of the night with Sutton back to serve once again. And another service error there, and I mentioned the service errors for Southern Virginia. That's been a big problem so far this year. Coming into today's game, they've had 313 service errors on the season, along with 162 service aces. But you also look at Juniata, they're in a similar boat, if not worse. 330 service errors on the year and 131 service aces. And speaking of service errors and aces, there's an error right there. But I think another picture, too, we need to look at is the amount of receiving errors. Southern Virginia so far this year has done a pretty good job at serve receive. It's really been able to help them set up a lot of their plays. Only 36 so far this year, whereas Juniata has 75. So we'll see if that comes into play here in tonight's contest. We have Tyler Schaefer back to serve. And that's going to be tipped up. Point for Juniata. That is Tyler Phillips, sophomore from Long Island, New York. And now we'll have number 18, Campbell Gerdeman, back to serve, the junior from Carlsbad, California. Nice float serve there. Is Bianchin able to get that one to fall off the hand of number 8, Chris Meller. And Meller, the tallest player on the floor for either side, standing at 6'9", just 2 inches taller, or 1 inch taller, than Kyler Evans for Southern Virginia. Christian Schaefer serve. Brown able to get in front of that one. And Goldsboro able to get through that one as well. Ties it up at 7 apiece. Got some substitutions for the Eagles. Number 13, Andrew Perhamus. As well, come back on the floor is Luke Hoffman. Set up for Brown. Bianchi was able to get his hand on it, but he was too far off the net. So that goes down as a kill for Luke Hoffman. And the Eagles take back the lead. Neither side really able to establish any sense of momentum so far in the early goings of this one. Here's Canlin. Straight down. Fantastic work from Canlin. He's really coming to his own the past couple of weeks, really taking control and taking charge. And a lot of the home games they've had over the past 2 weeks. Here's Christo Bianchin back to serve for Southern Virginia, the junior from Sao Paulo, Brazil. Goldsboro, that was way high. Point to Southern Virginia, they take back the lead.
Score, Knights 9, Eagles 8.
We'll have Bianchin back to serve once again. And Brown able to get a hand on it, but the power from Luke Hoffman was too strong. Ties it back up at 9 with Reese Ganter back to serve. Another senior from Reading, Pennsylvania. Trying to set it up for Evans.
Knights into the net. Point,
Eagles. They're going to say that he went into the net, so score, the Eagles take back the lead. Now 10-9 here in the first set. Here's Ganter. That one into the net. Make it service error number 3 for the Eagles. Both teams are tied in that category now. And fittingly enough, that makes it tied up again at 10 points apiece. Here's Sam Canlin. Back-to-back service errors. Gives Juniata College back the lead. Back the lead. Another service error ties it up at 11. And again, I mentioned how this is easily the biggest matchup of the year for both teams in the regular season. You can kind of see that the players feel it. A ball had been thrown into play before Jeremy Brown could get the serve off, and so they have to restart it. But again, you got to imagine the intensity, the importance of this matchup both in conference and nationally is sitting in the minds of players on both sides. So I guess the main question at the end of the day is which team is going to be able to put that aside enough to come out with a win today and make the least amount of mistakes.
Checking in for the Eagles, number 8, Chris.
Got another substitution, number 8, Chris Meller. We'll come back in for the Eagles. And now number 20, Luke Hoffman, back to serve. Another service error.
Point Knights.
And we'll see Maxim Sutton come back onto the floor to serve for the Knights. The Knights really wanted to create some separation here. They've had several sets so far this year where things were pretty tight going into about the 12th or 13th point. And then after that, the Knights kind of take control. But against a team like Juniata College, you imagine that'd be a lot more difficult to do. And that's going to be in just inside that back line. And Juniata College takes back the lead.
Back to serve.
And we'll see Kyler Evans come back onto the floor. Now back to serve is Tyler Phillips. Tyler Schaefer, fantastic work. The first pass is a little long, so it'd have been tough to make a play on it, but Schaefer saw the opening and attacked, tying it back up at 13. Here's Tyler Schaefer back to serve. Good dig from Brown. Coming from the back row. And the Knights take back the lead. If you had any question on how good Jeremy Brown is feeling coming into this game, it was answered right there. No problem with both defense and then flying in for the kill. Tyler Schaefer back to serve again. Good work keeping it alive. Brown from the back row again. And I believe touching that one was Campbell Gerdeman. And so ties it back up now at 14 apiece with 14. Number 18, Campbell Gerdeman, back to serve.
Back to serve, Gerdeman.
That one into the net. Juniata College now with 6 service errors in this first set.
Back to serve for the Knights, number 11, Christian Schaefer.
Now of Christian Schaefer back to serve. Christian Schaefer so far not able to do much as, of course, being a multiple-time player of the week in the conference, everyone knows to look out for him. So tied back up at 15 with number 13, Perhamus, checking in to serve. That set just a little high for Bianchi, but able to get his hand on it. Ball coming this direction, and that goes down for Goldsboro. And the Eagles take back the lead. So again, neither team really giving up much of an inch at all. That setup for Bianchi was right on time. Bianchi found the opening in that back row and ties it up once again.
Cristo to serve.
And now here's Bianchi back to serve. Tipped up and off the light. That time the ceiling hurting the Knights.
Phillips with the kill.
Ganter, so now back to serve is Ganter. I'd say what the back row of Juniata College so far, especially on serve receives, considering the stats on the year, they've done a fantastic job of setting themselves up. Get up, get up, get up, get up. Evans dove and tried to get his hand underneath it, but they called it on the floor. And so for the first time in a long time, a team has a multiple point lead, and this time it's Juniata College. Ganter back to serve once again. Good first pass. Here's Schaefer coming from the back row. Ganter able to get underneath it. Mattson to Canlin. Goldsboro. Another call in the net.
Knights in the net.
On Southern Virginia, so a three-point lead for Juniata College, and Southern Virginia forced to take a timeout. And Juniata College having a lot of momentum right now. A couple plays really going their way, getting a couple of calls their direction as well. And again, you just feel the tension in this room right now. Both teams know exactly what this game means for the course of their season. And Southern Virginia also feeling the extra pressure because, again, I've mentioned many times that Southern Virginia yet to lose even a single set so far this year. So the pressure of that definitely mounts for certain. And during this break, I want to give a shout-out to athletic partners of Southern Virginia University, including River Crossing Apartments, Straws Drinks and Eats, Mill Creek Orthodontics, Cornerstone Bank, Papa John's locally owned and operated, Vinyl Cuts, Katana Sushi and Hibachi Express, The Beef, Sweet Souvenirs, and Grace Automotive, where SVU students and staff get 10% off their vehicle maintenance needs. So far today, again, early story was service errors, both teams going back and forth. Juniata, of course, leading now that department by one service error. Juniata's hitting percentage has been pretty decent so far, considering the tight matchup this has been. 421 compared to Southern Virginia's 267. Juniata College also having four more total attacks than Southern Virginia has, with 19 compared to Southern Virginia's 15. So Southern Virginia needing to dig deep here if they want to take this first set. The Knights really having to scramble to get that one back over. That one was out. At first, Juniata College thinking it was a kill for them. It was the up ref who had to make that call. Coach Glenn DeHaven of Juniata College wanting clarification from the refs there. I've had the chance to talk to Coach DeHaven on a couple occasions in his eighth season. Service error once again for Sam Canlin.
Out to the Eagles. Back to serve number five, Goldsboro.
That makes three for Canlin so far in this first set. So now 20-17 is the score. Back-to-back service errors that time from Goldsboro.
Jeremy Brown back to serve for the Knights.
So we'll have Jeremy Brown back to serve for Southern Virginia. What a setup that time for Hoffman from Ganter. And Southern Virginia did not see that one coming whatsoever. Another three-point lead for the Eagles. That one's skimming the top of the net, Schaefer. And a block that time for Tyler Phillips. Momentum pretty much all on Juniata College's side right now. Another timeout for Southern Virginia as they are on the verge of losing their, or having their first set loss in this 2024 season. Just 3 points away from that being the case. And you know, you look at Juniata College, again, being a fantastic team, 18-4 overall, number eight in the nation. And understandably, feel like they have something to prove here. I mentioned earlier the history between these two programs. The last time the Knights lost to the Eagles was back in 2018 on February 3rd. And since then, Southern Virginia has kind of dominated the series. There have been some close games here and there, but the Knights have been able to get eight straight wins since that first meeting back in 2018. And so you think for Juniata, you're going into the home gym of the number two team in the nation. They're undefeated. They haven't lost a set. You haven't beaten them since 2018. You know, that's a lot of motivation. And, you know, I'm sure Coach Glenn DeHaven had pretty much emphasized that during practice all week this week, saying, hey, guys, it's been a long time. Let's go in there to their home gym and upset them. But for Southern Virginia, of course, you want the ride to continue. You want the momentum to keep on swinging in your direction. And in this first set, aside from a couple of plays, Southern Virginia's kind of been a little flat-footed. So we'll see after that timeout if they're able to yank some momentum away from the Eagles of Juniata College. So now back to serve is Luke Hoffman. Tyler Schaefer able to win the best of that exchange. Mattson. Tyler Schaefer digging that out of the net. What a wild play, but it works out for the Knights.
Christian Schaefer with a kill.
They bring it back within three, and Maxim Sutton back on the floor to serve.
Maxim Sutton.
What fantastic work there from Tyler Schaefer to dig it out of the net. Here's Sutton. Beautiful block with a combo of Crystal Bianchin and Christian Schaefer.
Maxim Sutton back to serve.
Timeout, Juniata.
Juniata College now calling timeout, trying to stop the momentum swing for Southern Virginia. And I tell you what, one of the toughest things to do in the sport of volleyball, both men's and women's, is to serve right after a timeout. You've kind of had a chance to cool down for a sec. You kind of, you know, get your mindset. You have to switch it off and then switch back on again. And so for Maxim Sutton, a lot of pressure riding on this next serve. The Knights already having a couple of service errors so far in this first set with six to their name. And so the big question is, will Maxim Sutton be able to put it in play for the Knights of Southern Virginia coming out of the timeout? Looking at some statistical leaders right now. For Juniata College, you got Tyler Goldsboro with five kills so far, Tyler Phillips with two, Campbell Gerdeman with two, and Luke Hoffman with two. For Southern Virginia, you have Krista Bianchin leading the way with two, Samuel Canlin with two, Jeremy Brown with one, and Tyler Schaefer with one kill as well. And Reese Ganter having a fantastic first set, 10 assists. Tyler Schaefer has six, just a little behind Ganter. So as I mentioned before, after the timeout, we'll see Maxim Sutton go back behind the line and serve once again. Knights looking to mount a comeback here in the first set. Ganter. Canlin to Tyler Schaefer. Knights have a chance to set something up here. And collision between Crystal Bianchin and Sam Canlin. Miscommunication on the pass there, as I believe both Sam Canlin and Crystal Bianchin had backed away from it, expecting someone else to fly in and pass
back
it.
To serve the Eagles, number nine, Tyler Phillips.
So now it is 23-20 in favor of Juniata College. Back to serve is Tyler Phillips. I believe maybe the up ref was giving a little bit of a warning about some celebration on Juniata College's side. Service error for the Eagles. Brings it back within two. Here's Tyler Schaefer back to serve.
With the score 23-21.
And that block is going to land out of bounds. Point for Juniata College. The Knights trying to say that it had touched somebody on the other side. So now set point for the Eagles. And subbing in number six, Grant Lorelli. And serving is Campbell Gerdeman. Here's Christian Schaefer. Bianchin, able to get that through. The Knights stay alive in the set.
Piso, through the block, point Knights.
Now Christian Schaefer back to serve. Ganter comes back onto the floor for the Eagles. Go. Another great first pass from the Eagles. And just like the Knights dropped their first set of the year, 25-22 to the Eagles of Juniata College. And I think, you know, when you look at that set, one main thing sticks out to me is the fact that Juniata College had fantastic first passes consistently throughout the entirety of the set. So they were able to get into a bit of a rhythm, set up their plays, get some good passes and sets to the outside, where Southern Virginia kind of struggled in that department, getting good first passes. So in many plays, they had to start scrambling around and try to make something out of nothing. And so in this second set, you'd imagine Southern Virginia is looking to correct that, trying to make sure they can get more clean looks. And another thing to consider, too, is that now that Southern Virginia has finally lost a set this year, maybe there's a bit of a monkey off their back, or maybe there's a bit of weight lifted off their shoulder, thinking, okay, we've lost the set, let's get back to what we do best. Now the pressure is gone, no longer have to worry about that streak, or even if they weren't worrying about it, subconsciously still think about it as a player. Now that that's gone, you think, okay, now we can operate, let's let loose, let's get a little taste of revenge. And so I'm sure that's what Southern Virginia is looking to do here in set number two, and what has been a fantastic matchup. And folks, if that first set was any indication of what we're in for tonight, I think we're in for quite a treat as far as quality of volleyball is concerned. I want to remind you, you're watching this on Knights Broadcasting here on YouTube. Be sure to give us a like, subscribe, comment down below your highlight of that first set, as well as ways we can improve this viewing presentation of Southern Virginia Athletics. We appreciate your support of both Knights Athletics and Knight Broadcasting. Once again, if you're just joining us, this is a top 10 Division III matchup between the Eagles of Juniata College and the number 2 ranked Knights of Southern Virginia. Juniata College came in, took a lot of momentum late in that first set, and took set number one 25-22. Despite Juniata College having more service errors than Southern Virginia with 8, but again, having 5 more total attacks than Southern Virginia, and having a higher hitting percentage on average. Juniata College had about 346, Southern Virginia with 238. And so looking to see more clean, characteristic play from Southern Virginia in set number two. And we'll see if the Knights can also limit the service errors, because that has been the one main weak spot so far this year, consistently anyway, has been service errors. So if they can limit that in set number two and three, and of course set number four, they could be in business here. Some statistical leaders so far, we got Goldsboro with 5 kills still. Campbell Gerdeman working his way up now with 4 kills. Luke Hoffman with 3 and Tyler Phillips with 2. For Southern Virginia, you have Crystal Bianchine with 3. Sam Canlin with 2, Jeremy Brown with 1, and Tyler Schaefer with 1. And Reese Ganter having 12 assists in that first set. He's actually going to be back to serve to start set number 2. Both teams tied in blocks so far today with 2 apiece. And we'll see libero number 2, Peter Carriato, come onto the floor. He has 80 digs on the year.
Back to serve for the Eagles, number 4, Reese Ganter.
As mentioned before, Ganter will start things off for the Eagles in set 2. Now, one thing you do like to see is that when Juniata College took the momentum late in that first set, the Knights fought back and made it more interesting. Slide set up for Christian Schaefer, able to get the best of Goldsboro that time. The Knights take a 1-0 lead.
Point Knights. Tyler Schaefer.
Now Tyler Schaefer back to serve. Nice serve there from Schaefer. Another good first pass. Back row. Matt's in the pass. Schaefer to Canlin. Good block that time with a combination of Phillips and Hoffman.
Point Eagle. Back to serve.
So far, Juniata College making things frustrating for Sam Canlin. He has a handful of service errors. Been blocked on a couple occasions. Now Goldsboro back to serve. That is a service error for the Eagles.
Point Knights. Christian Schaefer back to serve.
Gives the Knights back the early lead with Christian Schaefer back to serve. Yes. Great job there from Hoffman, able to get past the block as the Southern Virginia ties it back up at two. Here's Hoffman back to serve. Brown first pass. Here's Bianchin. Here's Brown now. That one goes down. Brown fired up after that play. Christian Schaefer doing a good job of backing up on the first attack. Now Christo Bianchin back to serve. Brown is going to get another point here.
Off the block and out. Point nine.
We did see Chris Meller getting his hand on it, but ended up flying on the other side of the court out of bounds. Knights now have a two-point lead here with Bianchin back to serve again. Again, another great first pass for Juniata. Goldsboro flying in for the kill.
Point Eagles. Phillips back to serve.
Here's Phillips back to serve. Again, that's been the distinction between Southern Virginia and Juniata so far, is that Juniata has just had fantastic first passes consistently. Here's Christian Schaefer flying in.
Point Eagles.
That hit flying way out and ties it up at four apiece. Another golden opportunity there for Southern Virginia, not able to capitalize. Now Tyler Phillips back to serve. Service error for the Eagles.
Point Knights.
Makes that number 10.
Back to serve for the Knights, number 9, Sam Canlin.
Here's Sam Canlin. Another service error for Canlin. You can just tell he's visibly frustrated so far today. That is service error number 4 for him. Now back to serve is Campbell Gerdeman. Kyler Evans trying to dive forward and get to it. But another point for Juniata. Here's Gerdeman again. Good back row work. Brown went over the net, going for it. It wasn't really necessary.
Gerdeman to serve.
And he very clearly went over, so now a 2-point lead for the Eagles. Here's Gerdeman again. Another serve into the net. That's been the saving grace for Southern Virginia so far today, as a Juniata College has had many opportunities to really get things going, take a couple of extensive leads, at least by 2 or 3 points. Southern Virginia getting some breaks with their serves, though. That one's going to be just out off the hand of Goldsboro. He's had a fantastic night so far today with 6 kills so far. Here's Jeremy Brown back to serve once again. Goldsboro trying to strike again. Once again, some miscommunication on the passes for Southern Virginia, but Christian Schaefer able to get the best of Jeremiah Burden in the back row. Brings
That's
it back.
For
Southern Virginia now with a 1-point lead. Here's Brown. That is the first that service error for the Knights in this second set, doing a lot better off. Starting things off in the set compared to the 6 service errors in the first. Now subbing in for the Eagles, number 13, Andrew Perhamus. Sophomore from Easton, Pennsylvania. Schaefer special incoming. Eagles do a good job of containing it. And once again, striking is Tyler Phillips. As the Eagles take back the lead, now 9-8. Evans able to get through that block attempt from Goldsboro. Ties it back up at 9. And we'll see Maxim Sutton come back onto the floor for Southern Virginia to serve. And again, it's just been back and forth and back and forth. Whenever either team gets a little bit of momentum, the other team strikes back. That's just a sign of two well-coached teams going head-to-head. Another high-flying effort there from Campbell Gerdeman flying in from the back row. Southern Virginia having no answers for that so far. And now back to serve is setter number 4, Reese Ganter. Ganter now with 15 assists so far. Skims the top of the net. Schaefer able to get through. I believe that was both Tyler Phillips and Luke Hoffman. Ties it back up at 10 apiece. Here's Tyler Schaefer. That one skimming the top of the net as well. Bianchi able to get his hand on that one from Hoffman, but it goes down to the point for the Eagles.
Goldsboro back to serve.
Now Goldsboro back to serve for Juaniata. Having just taken a 1-point lead again.
Off the block
and that's going to go off the hand of Hoffman. It's going to fly out, tying it up at 11 apiece now. With Christian Schaefer back to serve.
Christian Schaefer back to serve.
Seen some friendly banter at the net between Canlin and Hoffman. Matson doing a great job of trying to fly up. And Juaniata getting the point that time. As Knights had blockers there, but no one backing them up. So now we'll have Hoffman back to serve. And it hit the ceiling, going over, so point for the Eagles.
Hoffman to serve.
Again, serve receive has just been a little bit more tricky for Southern Virginia than for Juaniata so far. That being a prime example of it. Now Hoffman back to serve again. Good first pass here. Christian Schaefer flying through.
Christian Schaefer.
Finally, we're starting to see Christian Schaefer gain a little momentum as he wasn't really able to do much in that first set. And now he has 2 kills on the night with Crystal Bianchi back to serve. A little problem with the ball that Crystal Bianchi was about to use. He was saying the ball was flat. And that one out off the attack from Chris Miller. So ties it back up at 13. Coach DeHaven getting confirmation from both the up and down ref to make sure that it was out. It was a little close. At first glance, it did look close. But both refs confirming that it was indeed out. Good serve from Bianchi. That one's sailing out.
Point Eagle.
After some hesitation, they're going to say that it was tipped at the net by Southern Virginia. They had initially signaled towards Southern Virginia's direction. But instead, the point goes to Juaniata. A yellow card is issued towards Southern Virginia. Tyler Schaefer talking with the up ref about what just happened. I believe that is called on Bianchi. Bianchi trying to argue that he didn't say anything. Now conversation between Bianchi and the down ref here. Trying to clear some things up. I believe we'll now be getting back to play here. Now within 1 point for Juaniata, with Tyler Phillips back to serve. Canlin is going to try to fly in, and it's going to go out on the other side.
Point Eagles, Phillips to serve.
And Juaniata now with a 2-point lead. I believe there was a scoreboard correction that needed to be made, and so indeed it is a 2-point lead for the Eagles. And service error once again, that time by Phillips.
Checking in for the Knights, number two.
And checking in for the first time tonight for Southern Virginia is number two, Jayton Hall, Jr. from Quinn Creek, Arizona. I believe they're going to hope that he can help on the back row. It's 51 digs so far this year. Mattson flying in, keeping it alive. And that's going to be just in for Juaniata. Southern Virginia really arguing that it was out. Coach Peterson really pleading his case. Making the motion of, I saw the ball land out. Still some deliberation happening here. And so it will be point to Juaniata. And I do love what I saw just now from Tyler Schaefer. You know, Christo Bianchi had a little bit of a reaction to that call, and Tyler Schaefer put his hand on him, told him to go back, and kept a lot of his teammates at bay. Good job from Brown and Evans, responding with the block that time, bringing it back within one. Jeremy Brown back to serve. The Knights doing a good job responding after a difficult call. And a long stoppage in play afterwards. Good job from Hall. Schaefer ties it up at 16. The energy is suddenly back on Southern Virginia's side and in the stands. Here's Brown. Once again, Hall doing a good job backing him up. Brown. I'm going to say over the net for Southern Virginia. Not quite sure exactly who was on. But it's going to award a point to the Eagles. So now Perhamus back to serve for Juaniata. Schaefer special strikes again. Ties it up at 17. Schaefer now with three kills, all coming in this set. Maxim Sutton coming back to serve.
Maxim Sutton.
What a fantastic hit that time. From Tyler Phillips. Tyler Phillips.
Cancer, back to serve.
He has four kills so far, but each time he's gotten the chance, it feels like he's delivering at a high level. And we'll see Ganter back to serve, the Eagles retaking the lead. Good pass from Christian Schaefer. And a great block from Goldsboro and Hoffman. 2-point lead now for the Eagles.
Ganter to serve.
Skimming the top of the net to Bianchin. Juaniata able to volley it back over. Here's Christian Schaefer. And trying to run underneath the net was Goldsboro. And it falls out of bounds. Great hustle, though, from number five. Point to Southern Virginia back within one. We'll see Sam Candlin come back onto the floor to replace Jayton Hall. And Tyler Schaefer back to serve. Schaefer with 15 assists so far today. The ceiling coming into play once again to hurt the Knights, making a 20-18 lead for Juaniata College. And again, the back row for Juaniata, along with number 11, Jeremiah Burden, has been unstoppable. Goldsboro back to serve. First time in a while, but Juaniata College has another service error. Brings it back within one. Another fantastic play there from
Hoffman back to serve.
That was Phillips once again flying in. Now Hoffman back to serve, 2-point lead for the Eagles. Actually going to award that to Goldsboro when it flew in. That's going to sail out. Way long from Campbell Gerdeman. Some mistakes from Juniata College keeping Southern Virginia alive. Christo Bianchin back to serve. Good dig there from Tyler Schaefer. Here's Candlin. Candlin again. My goodness, getting on top of it. Lands it right in front of Jeremiah Burden. And staring down the opposing side. Candlin is fired up. The down ref talking to Jeremy Brown. Basically trying to cool things down, trying to keep things civil here in the barn. It's been an intense one, folks. So tied up at 21. See Christo Bianchin coming in here, congratulating Candlin. As, again, I mentioned before, it's been a frustrating night for Sam Candlin so far, so getting a play like that to land had to feel good. Here's Bianchin. Ganter. Right beside Bianchin in the back row after the hit from Campbell Gerdeman. Another lead for Juniata. Now Tyler Phillips back to serve. Here's Evans. Gets that one to fall. Ties it back up at 22 apiece.
Jason Hall into the
Sam Callen talked to the down ref, apologizing for his emotions a couple plays ago. Jayton Hall checking back in for the Knights to serve. That one flying out. Point for Southern Virginia. And for the first time in a long time, Southern Virginia has a lead.
Timeout, Juaniata.
And Juaniata timeout here called by Coach Glenn DeHaven. Trying to talk things over as Southern Virginia having a little bit of momentum, hoping to come away and steal this set and tie things up at one set apiece. Again, what a fantastic game it has been, folks. I mentioned at the beginning of this broadcast, this will probably be one of the best volleyball matchups we'll see at the Division III level this year, and it has turned out to be so. Hasn't necessarily been the cleanest, but the talent has been abundant on both sides. The high-flying ability, the intensity, the emotions have been extremely high, exactly what you expect to see from a number one versus number two team in the conference matchup, as well as a match between two top 10 teams nationally. It's been absolutely fantastic to see. And during this break, I want to give another shout out to our athletic partners, River Crossing Apartments, Straws, Drinks and Eats, Mill Creek Orthodontics, Cornerstone Bank, Papa John's, locally owned and operated, Vinyl Cuts, Katana Sushi and Hibachi Express, The Beef, Sweet Souvenirs, and Grace Automotive. Thank you so much for partnering with Southern Virginia Athletics. We appreciate you. A lot of great local businesses here in the area that I personally frequent quite a bit, including a lot of the restaurants here in town. I mean, every small town needs great places to eat, and Buena Vista definitely has just that. Jayton Hall back to serve for Southern Virginia once again. Service error for Jayton Hall. Ties it up at 23.
Back to serve
now with Campbell Gerdeman back to serve. Hall's got to quickly shake that off. Here's Hall. Schaefer trying to put that one away. Diving for that one was Brown, sending it back over Schaefer. The rally continues. It's still going, but it's going to sail out of bounds.
Goodman back to serve.
Justin Mattson, in frustration, rips his jersey down the front. As now it's set point for the Eagles of Juaniata. And so I believe they're discussing having to get him another jersey from the locker room. I mean, what a rally that was. Both teams keeping it alive by the skin of their teeth. Southern Virginia having Jeremy Brown diving down the side. And I believe it was off the foot of another player on the second go-round.
Timeout, Southern Virginia.
And a timeout called. And the Knights down by one, set point for Juniata College. Juniata looking to take a 2-0 lead over the undefeated Knights of Southern Virginia, over the number two nationally ranked team in the nation at the Division III level. So Justin Mattson will now be wearing number 21. And there was visible frustration from Christian Schaefer after that play, directed toward Justin Mattson. We're not really privy to the information of what was discussed in that conversation. But again, it's clear that things have been frustrating for the Knights for the majority of this game. In the second set, there have been times where the Knights have kind of stormed back, had some momentum with hits from Christian Schaefer and Sam Canlin, and then times they kind of shoot themselves in the foot, most recently with the service error that resulted in tying things back up at 23. But now Juniata College has a chance to close out this second set. Behind the line now is number 18, Campbell Gerdeman.
In for the Eagles, number 6, Grant Lorelli.
Schaefer to Brown. And that ties it back up at 24.
Jeremy Brown.
One of the easiest looking attacks we've seen from Southern Virginia tonight. Getting a first ball kill. Here's Brown to serve. There's Burden once again. Here's Christian Schaefer. Another kill. The Knights now at set point.
Point Knights.
With Jeremy Brown back to serve once again. And a timeout once again called by Coach DeHaven. As the Knights take their first lead in a couple of points, where it feels like a longer time, just because, again, this game has been so back and forth. It has been so intense. And for those just tuning in, it got so intense there for a moment that we saw a jersey get ripped in half from libero Justin Madsen for Southern Virginia after an intense rally where Juniata is able to come away with the point. And I want to remind you, you're watching this fantastic matchup on Knights Broadcasting here on YouTube. Be sure to give us a like, subscribe, comment down below your highlight of the game so far, and there's been plenty of them, as well as ways we can improve this viewing presentation of Southern Virginia Athletics. We appreciate your support of Knights Athletics and Knights Broadcasting. Also want to give a shout out to the producers, those who work the cameras, all those who are behind the scenes of Knights Broadcasting, all the people who work so diligently to bring this presentation to you, whether it be on your TV screen, on your computer, on your phone, on your iPad, whatever device you're watching or listening on, we appreciate you tuning in. Here's Jeremy Brown back to serve. The crowd alive once again for the Knights. Goldsboro going up, and the ball lands pretty much right at me. Getting involved in the game is always fun, but that ties it up at 25. With Perhamus back to serve for the Eagles. Schaefer special, not working that time. They're gonna try it again. Perhamus with the dig. That one from Goldsboro goes into the net. Set point once again for Southern Virginia. We'll see Maxim Sutton come onto the floor to serve.
Maxim Sutton. Sutton back to serve.
Here's Sutton. Service error. Again, it seems like every time the Knights get a little bit of an advantage and an opportunity, some small thing happens. So now Ganter back to serve, and this is one of those games where every opportunity you get, you have to take advantage of. You absolutely have to. Schaefer flying up and taking back the lead. And Sam Chandler checking in for Jayton Hall. And the Knights have a chance to close out this second set right here. Tyler Schaefer behind the line. Once again, the Knights have a chance to close things out, and a service error. Service error is now at 11 for Southern Virginia. Now with Goldsboro back to serve. And service error for the Eagles.
Side out to the Knights. Christian Schaefer.
So we're ending this set how we began the first set, with back-to-back service errors. Christian Schaefer now back to serve. And flying in there is Hoffman to tie things back up at 28. This could easily go into the 30s, folks.
Number 20, Luke Hoffman. Into the match.
It will at the very least go to 30. Here's Hoffman back to serve. Good first pass. Christian Schaefer flying in. Good save from Tyler Schaefer. Canlin. Here's Brown. That's a good point to the Knights. Blocked out of bounds. The Eagles were right there. Weren't able to face inside enough. Now Crystal Bianchi back to serve. That's going to be tipped. Point back to the Eagles. My goodness.
Phillips back to serve.
And we'll see Phillips back to serve again for the Eagles. Only two service aces have happened in this game so far, both from Juaniata. And service error there gives the Knights back the lead. Jaden Hall back to serve for Southern Virginia after he subs in for Sam Canlin. Here's Hall. Here's Christian Schaefer flying in, and the Knights storm back to take set two, 31-29. Oh, folks, if we have more sets like this, I'm going to have gray hairs by the time this is over. I'm not even 30 yet. I mean, talk about intensity, talk about emotion. That set had it all, I mean, including extra points. Now things are tied up at one apiece. Southern Virginia doing a great job of responding after things were not going their way. Things were not working out for them. Their attacks were not as clean as they would like them to be. They had some service errors. They lost for the first time in a set this year. Could very easily have allowed that to make them, you know, retreat back and kind of doubt themselves a bit, but the Knights able to do the opposite. Come back, fight through adversity, and to take back that set as we're tied here 1-1. I mean, folks, it's been ridiculous. Looking at the stats right now, Christo Bianchi is having himself a night now with 12 kills. Excuse me, that's actually Christian Schaefer, 12 kills. Jeremy Brown with 5, Crystal Bianchi with 3, and Sam Canlin with 3. Christian Schaefer doing a good job of rebounding in that second set. Wasn't able to get much going at all in the first, as the Eagles really doing a great job at limiting what he could do. And then Goldsboro for Southern Virginia, or excuse me, for Juniata, has 9 kills. Gerdeman with 7, Hoffman with 7, and Phillips with 5. And you know, on previous broadcasts of men's volleyball, we've talked about the depth that Southern Virginia has, the different weapons they can go to. And I feel like for the first time this year, or one of the first times this year, they're facing an opponent in Juniata that has that exact same thing. They have depth. They have weapons all over the place. And they have a fantastic back row. I can't say it enough. Juniata's back row has really impressed me so far tonight, and is a big reason why things have been so close, and a big reason why they were able to take set number one away from the Knights of Southern Virginia. Want to once again give a shout out to our athletic partners. These are businesses who partner with Southern Virginia University, namely River Crossing Apartments, Straws Drinks and Eats, Mill Creek Orthodontics, Cornerstone Bank, Papa John's locally owned and operated, Vinyl Cuts, Katana Sushi and Hibachi, Express, The Beeve Sweet Souvenirs, and Grace Automotive. There are a number of those places that serve food that I'm sure a lot of these students want to go to after this is all said and done, as they'll have worked up an appetite with the emotions and the intensity that has been abundant in this CVC matchup. And again, a matchup of two top 10 teams in Division III men's volleyball. So as time winds down in the break between sets, it's back even. Basically thinking at this point, the 0-0. It starts all over. Build from here. And if you're Southern Virginia thinking, what do we do well in that set? Well, we fought back. We made some attacks work when most of the times they probably wouldn't have. We battled through emotional adversity. Now, what are things you didn't do well? At the end, you kind of hurt yourself with service errors. Juniata College did the same thing, and that's a big reason why it went back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. So we'll see if either team is really able to take momentum in this set or if it's just going to continue to be more of the same of just this back and forth routine we have seen so far today. Down ref checking all those who are on the floor for both Juniata and Southern Virginia. And starting this set in the back row will be for Southern Virginia, number 8, Jaron Brown. He has not seen the floor at all tonight. But he'll be serving for the Knights. Knights looking for a little bit of spark serving-wise. Like we've mentioned, the service errors for both squads. Juniata now with 15, Southern Virginia with 11. Coach DeHaven of Juniata making a correction in his lineup. Instead of Hoffman starting off at the net, he'll have number 8, Chris Meller. He saw a little bit of time in those first two sets, was pretty effective. Hoffman, on the other hand, as well, has been supremely effective. 7 kills so far today. He's got a really high hitting percentage of 778. And he'll be on the bench to start off this set. So now they've made that correction, I believe now we can get back to play.
Back to serve for the Knights, number 8, Jaron Brown.
Here's Brown. Nice topspin on that one. Christian Schaefer diving. Here's Brown. Jeremy Brown, that is. Candlin having to just come in there and volley it over. Some miscommunication. Flying in there is Goldsboro, but Bianchine able to block it. Knights have a 1-0 lead. There have been a couple of situations where the Knights have had poor communication that has led to either scrambling for the ball or points for the Eagles. Jaron Brown's second serve is way, way far.
Gerdeman back to serve.
And now we'll have Gerdeman back to serve for the Eagles. Christian Schaefer flying up. That was a picture-perfect set. And Christian Schaefer able to capitalize now with 13 kills on the day. His brother Tyler Schaefer now back to serve. Service error for Tyler Schaefer ties it back up at 2 apiece.
Braham is back in. He's there to serve.
Perhamus is back to serve for the Eagles. Canlin flying in there. Bianchine just sending it back over. I believe that was blocked off of Bianchine's face. And ended up landing in bounds for a point for Southern Virginia. Now we'll have Christian Schaefer back to serve. Another service error. So back-to-back service errors for the Schaefer brothers. Ties it up at 3.
Ganter back to serve.
And we'll see Ganter back to serve once again. Ganter with 25 assists compared to Tyler Schaefer's 23. Both doing a fantastic job today. Canlin flying in.
Point Eagles. Ganter to serve.
The Knights are trying to point at the line judge on their side who said that it was tipped. So now the Eagles have the lead and, well, not anymore. Tied back up at 4 after that service error from Ganter. the crowd yelling, "Ball, don't lie." That's the unwritten rule of all athletics. If there's a questionable call, the next play kind of determines on if the call was right or not. Again, I need to see a replay to see if that was actually the case, if it was tipped. Goldsboro able to fly in there and get another kill. He's now in double digits.
Goldsboro back to serve for the Eagles.
Kyler Evans gets the rare look and knocks it down, tying it back up at five. Kyler Evans hasn't been targeted a lot today, but I'd imagine that might change after that play. So here's Jayton Hall back to serve. Well, before that, had to fix the antenna on the near side. And now we'll have Hall serve. Timing was off there for Juniata. Christian Schaefer flying in from the back row. Another long hit results in another point for the Eagles.
Hoffman back to serve.
Subbing back in for Juniata is number 8, Chris Meller. And we'll see Hoffman back on the floor, and he'll serve. That one's into the net, ties it back up.
Side out to the Knights. Jimbo back to serve.
Now Jeremy Brown back to serve. What a block from Tyler Schaefer. Gives the Knights back the lead.
Point Knights.
It's always fun to see Tyler Schaefer have a play like that because he's usually so stoic, but he has a play like that and he gets so excited and energetic. Schaefer, back-to-back time, saving the play. And the block from Christian Schaefer.
Christian Schaefer!
What a defensive play all around for Christian Schaefer. Saved it twice, then gets the block to end it, giving the Knights a 2-point lead. That one going way out. The Knights saying none of them touched it. I believe that is the truth. Now a 3-point lead for the Knights. I expect possibly to see a timeout from Coach DeHaven here if the Knights get this next point. Here's Brown. That one into the net. Another service error for the Knights.
Phillips back to serve.
It's now 9-7 with Phillips back to serve. Here's Christian Schaefer. Unable to corral at that time as Peter Carriato.
Jaron Brown back in for the Knights.
So now we'll have Jaron Brown serving the Knights with a 3-point lead. I believe matching their largest lead of the night. That serve from Brown long.
Side out to the Eagles.
And we'll see Kyler Evans come back onto the floor. Back to serve is Campbell Gerdeman. Schaefer to Schaefer. Making it look easy.
Schaefer special, point Knights. Sam Canlin back in for the Knights.
Canlin will check back in for Jayton Hall. And Tyler Schaefer back to serve for Southern Virginia. Once again, touched by the Knights. It kind of ricocheted a couple of times and landed on Southern Virginia's side, bringing it back within two with Perhamus back to serve. Christian Schaefer. That was a good job that time from Gerdeman.
Perhamis to serve.
Able to keep it alive for the Eagles and brings it back within one. Here's Canlin flying in, getting that kill. He had spent some time off the floor and I think felt like he had something to prove.
Christian Schaefer to serve.
Proving a lot with that hit just then. Canlin's had two of the most powerful hits of the night so far. Here's Christian Schaefer. Oldborough. They're going to call it in.
Gatcher back to serve.
Goldborough gets another kill. Make it 11 for him tonight. Second only to Christian Schaefer, who has 15. Here's Ganter. And Brown. Juaniata was into the net that time. Point to Southern Virginia.
Bustos back to serve.
And I think maybe Jeremy Brown saw that. And so instead of swinging hard at it, which would have probably resulted in a block because they had two blockers right there in perfect position, he decided to push it over a little late. Brown got his hand on it, but it's going to land out of bounds. Brings it back within one.
Goldsboro back to serve.
And we'll see Goldsboro back to serve once again. Goldsboro's had several service errors tonight.
Jason Hall back in for the Knights.
Including
Hall
one
back to serve.
In the extra points of the second set. Jayden Hall coming in for Sam Canlin. Service error for Hall.
Miller back in for
and
the
we'll
Eagles.
See Chris back Miller come back onto the floor for the Eagles with Hoffman back to serve. So now it's back within 1 point. Kyler Evans flying in. The Knights thought it was tipped, but it's going to be out. Coach Tom Peterson is trying to signal that the line judge on this side had signaled those out. Visibly frustrated by that call, so now it's tied at 14, and Tyler Schaefer talking to the up ref. So again, tied at 14.
Hoffman to serve.
And again, in a game like this where it's been so back and forth, every call counts. So you'll see a lot of protesting from either side when a call is questionable. Hall able to save it. Ganter diving. Mattson to Brown. And it's going to land out. Point to Southern Virginia. Great job from Jayden Hall. Able to collect himself after it ricocheted off a beam on the ceiling. Here's Jeremy Brown back to serve. It's going to ricochet off of Christian Schaefer's head as he went one-on-one against Tyler Phillips. Ties it back up at 15.
Phillips to serve for the Eagles.
And it's Phillips who will serve. That one into the net. That makes service error number 19 for Juaniata. And Maxim Sutton checking back in for the Knights to serve.
Back to serve.
A total of 36 service errors so far between these two teams. Goldsboro, that one way out. Gives the Knights a two-point lead.
Sutton to serve.
Sutton behind the line again. Ganter sprinting to that one. Good opportunity here. Bianchi coming in. It's going to be out. It looked like a clean set, too, with a lot of openings just coming off the hand of Bianchi wrong. So now back to serve is Campbell Gerdeman. The down ref. Down ref talking to Coach Tom Peterson here. That's going to be blocked out. Tyler Schaefer initially was trying to run a little trick play there, and it was tipped. Initially looked like it might have just gone into the net, but the up ref saying it was tipped. Eventually results in a point for Southern Virginia. Very lucky break there that it was called the way that it was. Here's Tyler Schaefer back to serve. Bianchi right there, and I'm going to say over the net, but what an effort from Reese Ganter to dive in there and keep it alive. Ganter's been doing that all night long. Now Ganter wanted to wipe off the floor in the area that he dove. I mean, obviously you have those who are leaders and kills in the game like Goldsboro and Gerdeman and Hoffman and Phillips. But in my opinion, the unsung heroes for Juniata that have really made a big difference for them has been, of course, Reese Ganter, as well as Jeremiah Burden, the junior libero from Palos Park, Illinois. Defensively, those guys have been a powerhouse, and Ganter, I haven't seen a single set from him that has been even close to being off course. Great work at the net by Bianchi.
Block party at the net, point night.
Now a four-point lead for Southern Virginia, and Coach DeHaven for Juniata calling a timeout. So after what felt like a real struggle in those first two sets, the Knights able to win one of them. This third set feels like the Knights have really started to kind of find themselves a little bit again. And honestly, it seems like they've been more excited in this third set. The first two sets looked like there's a bit of nerves going on, maybe a bit of frustration, and that kind of combining to less efficient play. This third set, it feels like they've kind of let go of that a little bit. They've kind of gotten back to, you know, the idea of, hey, this is a fun game. We're having a good time. We're a good team. Let's relish in that. And I think that's definitely the feeling that you've seen so far here in set number three. And for those just joining us, it's been an intense matchup between the Eagles of Juniata College and your Knights of Southern Virginia University. Juniata took the first set 25-22, giving the Knights their first set loss on the year, but the Knights are able to battle back in a back-and-forth set in set number two and win that one in extra points, 31-29. Now with the Knights having a four-point lead, reaching 21st, the Knights just need to strap in, execute, and hopefully come away with a victory here in set number three, make things a whole lot easier than themselves. They can really let loose in a potential set number four. Now with Tyler Schaefer back to serve for Southern Virginia. That serve gonna go out.
Side out to the Eagles.
So brings it back within three. And now we'll see Perhamus back to serve. Bianchi went hit it across off of the awkward first pass. Again, communication between, I believe, Jeremy Brown and Christo Bianchi was a bit off. And so Bianchine had that first pass. So now brings it back within two. Schaefer flying in.
Christian Schaefer.
For kill battle. Number 16 on the evening.
Christian deserves.
The bench for Southern Virginia chanting Schaefer special. And I always say that Schaefer special is not a complex meal to cook, ladies and gentlemen. You just need two ingredients, a set from Tyler, a kill from Christian, and you got yourself something tasty for Southern Virginia fans. That serve, though, not quite as tasty into the net. Brings it back within two with number four, Reese Ganter, back to serve. Christian Schaefer flying in again for kill number 17.
Point Knights. Christo back to serve.
Coach Tom Peterson preaching to his team, getting them fired up. Here's Bianchine behind the line. And that's going to go out off of Jeremy Brown. That's happened a couple of times, and the Knights are right there.
Goldsboro back to serve.
But it ends up bouncing off of their head or off of their upper arm near their shoulder, and so it ends up taking a weird bounce out of bounds. But that brings it back within two with Goldsboro back to serve. Canlin is going to get it. Well, they're going to say that it went out and no one touched it, so brings it back within one. Goldsboro back to serve once again. Here's Brown. That's being knocked out. Ganter on the verge of diving across the scores table to try to get to it. Jason, that went out Hall off the hands of Phillips and Hoffman. So now we'll have Jayton Hall subbing in to serve for the Knights. And again, Burden right there. Christian Schaefer back row, drops it down. Burden diving. Despite the best efforts of Juniata, Phillips not able to get it back over, so now set point for Southern Virginia. The Knights have a chance to take a 2-1 set lead.
Set point.
Knights fans are on their feet. Kyler Evans right there along with Jeremy Brown to close out the set. That third set was a lot more of what we're used to seeing from Southern Virginia, playing together, higher energy, more efficiency on their attacks. And that's a good thing to see if you're the Knight faithful. As again, I mentioned how this game started off with the Knights looking a little sluggish, looking a little disorganized. Communication wasn't quite where they wanted it to be. You know, there were moments where they were showing visible frustration, talking with one another. And now it seems to be getting back to the Knights as we're used to seeing them, as they now have a 2-set-to-1 lead over the number 8 ranked Eagles of Juniata College. Again, the Knights doing a great job of battling through adversity.
Thank you.
Adversity that they really haven't had a whole lot of this year in the early goings. Again, they've come out to a 20-0 overall record, 4-0 conference record, looking to advance that to 5-0 in conference. But I think, if one thing is clear so far, is that if Southern Virginia is number 2 in the nation, I think Juniata College should be a little higher up than 8 as well. I think they should be right up there with Southern Virginia in the top 5, because they really came here to play today. They've played at a high, high level and have made Southern Virginia earn every bit of those 2-set victories. And again, looking at the leaders right now, Christian Schaefer, after not really having anything in that first set, now has 18 kills to his name. And leader for Juniata is Tyler Goldsboro with 12, who didn't have as much success in that second set. He was kind of not really able to get into a rhythm like he was in the first two. It had a couple service errors as well. That kind of gets into your head a little bit. Nice did a good job of keying in. And the blocking for Southern Virginia in that third set specifically was so much better. There were still times where blocks went out of bounds, like I mentioned before, off of someone's head or their shoulders or whatnot. But the Knights doing a better job at being there. And that was the thing in the first set and most of set number two, is that there are many plays where Juaniata had no contesting at the net from Southern Virginia. There was no contest. There was no blockers there. The Knights, again, doing a better job of making that more of a reality, especially at the tail end of that third set. So I want to once again give a shout-out to our athletic partners, local businesses here in Buena Vista, Virginia. We got River Crossing Apartments, Straws Drinks and Eats, Mill Creek Orthodontics, Cornerstone Bank, Papa John's locally owned and operated, Vinyl Cuts, Katana Sushi and Hibachi Express, The Beef, Sweet Souvenirs, and Grace Automotive. Again, Grace Automotive, if you're a student or staff of Southern Virginia, you get 10% off your vehicle maintenance needs. I know it's definitely a nice thing to have right now. It's cheaper automotive care. And, of course, a lot of these great restaurants in town, like Straws Drinks and Eats, Papa John's, Katana, and The Beeve, all places that I have frequented many, many times. Delicious places, in fact. And, of course, you got other great businesses like Vinyl Cuts. Make great signs and banners. I've gotten many products from them myself. And so we'll look to kick off set number four here in the barn at Southern Virginia University here on Knights Broadcasting. We'll see if Juaniata can respond after the Knights took that third set by a score of 25-21. Service errors have been a big story so far tonight. Both teams equal at 19. And one thing that I hinted at before earlier in the game, Juaniata was doing a great job with their hitting percentage. Around 375 to 400 in the early goings. Now Southern Virginia climbing up over top of them with a 256 hitting percentage over Juniata's 190. And in the first two sets, Juniata College did a good job of just getting more attacks than Southern Virginia. A lot of that had to do with back row play, those first passes. And after the first two sets, Juniata had, I believe, about six or seven total more attacks than Southern Virginia did. Now Southern Virginia leads that category by two total attacks, 86 to 84. So again, a lot of that comes back down to the Knights doing a better job on serve receive and getting those first passes where they need to be so they can set up their hitters on the outside, get some good quick sets to the interior, which they're able to accomplish in that third set. Just able to accomplish a lot more all the way around. For Southern Virginia starting off this set, we have the starters, both Tyler and Christian Schaefer, Jeremy Brown, Christo Bianchin, Sam Canlin, and libero Justin Madsen. And for Juniata, you have Chris Miller, number 8. You have number 9, Tyler Phillips. Then you have Tyler Coldsboro, Luke Hoffman, and setter Reese Ganter, number 4.
Hoffman.
As well as number 18, Campbell Gerdeman. And it'll be Hoffman who serves first in what should be an intense set 4. Because, again, not only is this a conference matchup, those are intense enough as it is, but a top 10 nationally ranked matchup. Christian Schaefer flying in there, answering the call and giving the Knights an early lead.
Tyler Schaefer back to serve.
Gives Christian Schaefer kill number 20 on the night. And block for Crystal Bianchin.
Tyler Schaefer to serve.
So the Knights doing a good job so far of carrying over the momentum from the third set, into this fourth one. Tyler Schaefer back to serve. Goldsboro able to get that one to fall.
Side out to Eagles.
Goldsboro now with 13 kills.
Back to serve, number 9, Tyler Phillips.
We'll have Tyler Phillips back to serve. Sophomore outside hitter from Long Island, New York. Went to Walt Whitman High School. That serve just out for Phillips.
Christian Schaefer back to serve.
And the Eagles break 20 service errors tonight. Here's Christian Schaefer back to serve. That's going to be out off the left hand of Campbell Gerdeman. Gerdeman doing a great job on that first pass. It was going towards the outside, able to angle it towards Ganser in the middle. He's been doing that all night long. In fact, all the back row for Juniata has been doing that all night long. 4-1 is the lead for the Knights. Doing it once again. The slide. Good work that time from Chris Meller.
Side out to the Eagles. Back to serve.
Meller, the 6'9" freshman. And you can tell he's one of those guys where if Juniata can continue to cultivate him and use him as his career continues, he could be a monster of a force in the CVC. Bianchine flying in there, goes a little high. So points the Eagles, brings it back within one.
Gerdeman to serve.
Here's Gerdeman. Canlin, great job there from Carriato. Christian Schaefer trying to be tricky, doesn't put enough underneath it.
Point Eagles.
So it ties it up at four apiece. Gerdeman back to serve again. Here's Brown. Able to get that one on the line.
Jimbo.
And the Knights take back the lead.
Piso back to serve.
And we'll see Kyler Evans back on the floor. He was targeted once in that third set and it resulted in a kill for him. I kept saying we might expect to see more of that as the game continues, but we haven't quite yet. Here's Bianchine. Another kill goes down for Phillips. Ties it back up at five.
Perhamis back to serve.
Perhamis back to serve for Juniata College. That pass spinning off the fingertips. Brown winding up. Goldsboro able to get a kill out of that hectic play. And the Eagles take back the lead, 6-5. The Knights started off with their hair on fire. Got a couple point lead to start things off, and now Juniata College doing a great job of battling back. And Evans targeted, gets the kill once again. The efficiency of when they went to Evans tonight has been great. It just hasn't been that often. But it ties up at 6 apiece. Jayton Hall back to serve for the Knights. And going way out.
Ball sails wide.
Hoffman had the good setup from Ganser. I don't know if it was a little too high for him or if he slipped. I think he may have taken off a little awkwardly off the floor. So the Knights now have a 7-6 lead. Goldsboro had the opening. He only had Tyler Schaefer right there. And I think Goldsboro just kind of did a little bit of overthinking. Now a 2-point lead for the Knights. That one into the net. Gives the Knights their 20th service error on the evening. The Knights have done it less frequently as far as service errors is concerned as of late than Juniata College has. After the first set and a half, they've mostly cooled it down. Hall flying up. That's going to land out. Despite the great attempt and great hustle from Ganser.
Jimbo back to serve.
That was a good swing from Hall. Now with Jeremy Brown back to serve. And Goldsboro, smart play there. Targeting Christian Schaefer's torso on the right side, knowing it would bounce out. A very high IQ play. Brings it back within one. Good first pass from Mattson. Evans flying in. Another successful play for Kyler Evans. I think the Knights are starting to see that he's pretty successful.
Sutton back to serve.
We have Maxim Sutton in to serve. Schaefer being a little tricky, Hoffman able to secure it. Block for Christo Bianchin.
Block party at the net.
Sutton behind the line again, 3-point lead for the Knights. Tipped by Schaefer. Great diving effort there from Maxim Sutton. Great effort. Some substitutions happening here.
Meller back in for the Eagles.
For Juaniata, we will see Hoffman. Chris Meller back on the floor. And back to serve is Luke Hoffman. Hoffman with 7 kills so far today. One of the only 2 service aces on the night belongs to him as well. That one's going to go out. Give the Knights a 3-point lead.
Point Knights. Sam Canlin back in for the Knights.
And we'll see Sam Canlin back on the floor for Southern Virginia. He's had an off and on evening with 6 kills to his name. Tyler Schaefer serve hits the top of the net. Bianchin doing a good job of getting it up in the air. Bianchin, another block. That time against Chris Meller.
Point Knights. Tyler Schaefer back to serve.
Bianchin now with 4 blocks on the night. Just above Christian Schaefer, who has 3, and Kyler Evans with 2. That's another place that the Knights have dominated actually tonight, is at the net. And now back to serve is Tyler Phillips. After the service error. Good first pass from Christian Schaefer. Here's Canlin flying in. Great hustle from Juaniata. Good setup here. Schaefer. The Schaefer special strikes again. Great first pass from Justin Mattson. As the send-over from Peter Carriato was just a little slow to get there, so the Knights had plenty of time to react. Here's Christian Schaefer back to serve. And we saw Tyler Schaefer diving for that one, but it's going to land out. Point for the Eagles.
Gerdeman back to serve.
Now we'll see Gerdeman back to serve. Here's Canlin. That one fired directly at the bench on the far side. Canlin
serve.
Landing a little awkwardly into the net. So now it's only a 2-point lead for the Knights. Here's Brown. That one's going to be out. No tip that time. Now brings it back within 1. So a couple plays. The Knights had some decent looks, just not able to capitalize. With Gerdeman back to serve once again. Bianchin Nice quick set to the middle. The middle has been Southern Virginia's friend on offense so far today. Seen a couple plays of Kyler Evans. Now that time with Bianchine. And now Bianchine back to serve. Service error for Bianchine that time. And we'll see Perhamus in to serve for the Eagles. Just a 1-point game. Here's Brown. Good chance here. Here's Brown. That one's sailing out as well. The Knights, another open look, but going out. Now tied at 15.
Perhamus to serve.
Christian Schaefer flying in, able to split the blockers, and the Knights take back the lead.
Jason Hall checks in for the Knights.
We'll have Jayton Hall coming to serve. The Knights looking to end this right here, right now, with set number four. And good job there from Goldsboro, seeing the opening in the back row. There was nowhere or no one to be seen. And ties it back up at 16 with Reese Ganter back to serve. Difficult first pass. They're going to call four hits that time. And Juniata College takes back the lead, 17-16. You can feel the energy starting to dissipate from Southern Virginia. They need to corral themselves and take back momentum right here, right now, with Ganter back to serve again. Schaefer flying in. That one in. Ties it back up at 17.
Jimbo back to serve.
Schaefer now with 23 kills on the night. What a block for Christian Schaefer.
Block party at the net, point nine.
Schaefer and Evans were both there, but I think Schaefer got the most of it. The Knights take back the lead with Jeremy Brown back to serve. And Brown able to get that to fall between Ganser and Gerdeman in the back row.
Jeremy Brown to serve.
The Knights with a 2-point lead now. Wiping down the floor a little bit on Juniata's side. And now we'll see Brown serve again. That was Burden once again. And then Evans there. And getting the swing over top was number 21, Nathaniel Brown, freshman outside hitter from Souderton, Pennsylvania. This is the first time we've seen him here tonight. Able to make a big play in a big moment. Reaching up above both Tyler Schaefer and Kyler Evans on that play. Christian Schaefer and a block by Brown.
Goldsboro to serve.
And we'll see Goldsboro back to serve once again. DeHaven saving Brown till this very moment. Here's Evans. And it was tipped. Point to Southern Virginia. Knights the first to reach 20 in this fourth and potentially final set. We'll have Maxim Sutton check in for the Knights to serve.
15, Maxim Sutton to serve.
Good hit that time from Gerdeman. Goes out off the hand of Christian Schaefer. And now we'll see Hoffman back to serve. See Schaefer, Jayton Hall, and Brown. And Mattson in the back row for the Knights. Ready to receive. Tied at 20. Good block that time from Gerdeman. All of a sudden, the blocking has come alive for the Eagles. Hoffman back to serve again. That one long. Ties it back up at 21. Here's Sam Canlin checking back in for Jayton Hall and Tyler Schaefer back to serve. Folks, we could easily have another set that goes in extra points with how this thing is going so far. Good tip up. Brown trying to get it to drop. It's Burden. Here's Christian Schaefer. Gerdeman able to get it to fall. There was no one on that far side to back them up. So now 22-21 with Nathaniel Brown back to serve. He has not served all night. It's Bianchin able to get that one to fall. Coach DeHaven being a little playful as he kept it up in the air. And now tied at 22 apiece. Here's Christian Schaefer back to serve. And you absolutely know the Knights want to end this one here and now. It's been a long night. Goldsboro, that one's going to be out. Knights now with the advantage, 23-22. And a timeout called by Coach DeHaven and Juaniata. The Knights 2 points away from taking down the number 8 team in the nation and fighting back from losing set number 1, winning a close game in set 2, then once again a close one in set 3, and hoping to close out another close set in set number 4. Want to once again give a shout out to our athletic partners, local businesses here in Buena Vista, Virginia, River Crossing Apartments, Straws Drinks and Eats, Mill Creek Orthodontics, Cornerstone Bank, Papa John's locally owned and operated, Vinyl Cuts, Katana Sushi and Hibachi Express, The Beef, Sweet Souvenirs, and Grace Automotive. And also want to remind you, you're watching what has been a fantastic game here on Knights Broadcasting here on YouTube. Be sure to give us a like, subscribe, comment down below your highlight of the game. As I mentioned before, there have been plenty of them. And let us know how we can improve this viewing presentation of Southern Virginia Athletics. We appreciate your support of Knights Broadcasting.
Tyler Schaefer back to serve.
Here's Christian Schaefer. Knights just need 2 points to close it out. Ganter to Brown. Bianchin got his hand on it. The Eagles have to rally. Bianchin. It's going to bounce or tap on the ceiling. So out of bounds. And so the Knights now have set point.
Everybody on your feet. Christian Schaefer back to serve.
Conversation happening here between the down ref and some players from Juniata and Coach DeHaven. I believe what Reese Ganter is trying to say is that before it went over, after touching the ceiling, that he had touched it.
Timeout.
So after that play, another timeout called by Juniata as Knights are at set point. Chance to close things out in set number four. I mean, again, I tell you what, folks, it's been everything you could have wanted from a fantastic CVC conference match between the top teams of the conference and two teams that are in the top 10 in Division III rankings, according to the ABCA coaches poll. Again, we're looking at the statistical leaders. You got Christian Schaefer, who exploded after not really having much of a first set with 23 kills in today's game. I would not be surprised that helps him in a case to be CVC Player of the Week once again, as he's done that multiple times now this year. Tyler Goldsboro also having a fantastic night, 16 points, not as consistent as he would like it to be, especially including some service errors. You also have Luke Hoffman for Juniata with 10 kills, and then Jeremy Brown for Southern Virginia with 10. And Tyler Phillips having a great night as well with 9 kills to his name. Kyler Evans has really come alive as well in the last set with 7 kills to his name. And then blocks, again, I mentioned the blocks for Southern Virginia. Crystal Bianchi with 4, Christian Schaefer with 4, Kyler Evans 2.5, and Jeremy Brown with 1.
All right, it's match point.
So now, Christian Schaefer back to serve what could potentially be the game-winning point. Set point here in set number 4. The Knight faithful are on their feet. Good serve there. Right back to Gerdeman. Bianchin went over the net, and indeed he did. He had folded his wrist over when it wasn't really necessary. It was already going down. So brings it back within 1. That could have sealed it right there if it weren't for that mental lapse. Here's Brown. And that closes it out. Southern Virginia takes it 3-1 over the Eagles of Juniata College. Again, huge props to the Eagles of Juniata taking the first, or beating Southern Virginia in a set. That's something that no other team has done so far this year, really making the Knights earn every single bit of this victory here tonight. And Southern Virginia showing their ability to fight through adversity when it confronts them. The Knights now advance to 21-0 on the season, 5-0 in conference play, and will no doubt remain atop of the CVC conference rankings. Juniata College suffers their 5th loss of the year, their first since February 3rd against number 3 Stevens. So it's been a long time since they had suffered a loss, but again, a huge prop to their team. This could be a game where you might see this rematch in the conference tournament. And if that happens, folks, you're going to want to see that. And I wouldn't be surprised if it happens in the conference championship game. You're going to want to be there to watch that game because it's going to be a good one, just like this one was here today. And with that being said, thank you so much for joining us here on Knights Broadcasting. I'm Dawson Weidrich. This has been an absolute blast to watch another presentation of Southern Virginia Knights men's volleyball. Hope you have a great night, and go Knights.